the scenes in Yellowstone Park, made in 1947. That was our first trip to the park. This is some of their geyser. In the old big geyser basin there in Yellowstone Park. These geysers are, of course, formed by the heat from the thermal activity way beneath the crust of the earth. Castle Geyser is limestone formation that's formed by the geyser eruptions over the millions of years. This is the lodge at Old Faithful Geyser. Lunch out of a spam can that we threw in. This is a, it's an overall view of Yellowstone Lake. That's old Charlie. He was, before he started school, he was just about 6 years old. That's one of the mud geysers. I believe they call this the growler. It's just a sea of boiling hot muddy water. Just some of the scenery along the Yellowstone River. This is one of the falls along the Yellowstone River. Not a very clear picture, but that's what they call the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. This is a view looking across Jackson Lake in the Jackson Hole country, and that's the Grand Teton Mountains in the background. And a nice little herd of elk there in the Jackson Wyoming country, Jackson Hole, Wyoming country. Wish we could see them better. That's the best I can give you. There's another view of the Grand Tetons, looking from the west, looking from the east towards the west along the highway. It's a magnificent sight. You look closely here, there's a moose going up the side of the road there. Here's some beautiful scenic cliff areas over in the Badlands of Wyoming. This is on east of Yellowstone Park. And what a herd of horses. Take a good look. This is just a scene around Lander, Wyoming. It's just a big basin there in the mountains. Now we're into some of the scenic areas of Colorado and around on the highway. Rolling down the Colorado Highway in our 1950 Buick station wagon. Fire scene along the highway in northern Idaho. This is right outside of Yellowstone Park. This is on a vacation trip that your mother and I made. The field everywhere you look was just rife with wildflowers, all different colors and varieties. That for a bouquet of wildflowers. The field was just covered with wildflowers. This is a lodge at Island Park Reservoir in Northern Idaho. Back during World War II, that was before that lodge was even built. That Island Park Reservoir was my first rainbow trout fishing experience. And you talk about some fish now. We caught, there was four of us went fishing, and we caught about 25 fish that averaged around 6 pounds apiece. Now this is just going north from that Island Park Reservoir, headed towards Yellowstone Park in Montana. We're just traveling down the highway in our 1950 Buick station wagon. Entering the state of Montana there, which is just right out of West Yellowstone, Montana. This is Tom McRae. He was my boss when I first went to work for Jack Ammon in San Antonio, and we had stopped in West Yellowstone. And needless to say, we were enjoying the ice cream. This is just some scenes along the highway northbound out of West Yellowstone, Montana, headed towards Missoula. This is Hebgen Lake along the highway. It's a lake along the Madison River, which is really part of the headwaters of the Missouri River, I believe. I think this is an area that you well remember in your younger, more carefree days. This is scenes of Ennis Lake, our old favorite fishing hole. Here's old Papa out on the lake. We're cruising along the lake trolling for rainbow trout. That's not a trout. Can you believe wooden boats? They did. Sometimes they had motors on them. This is our modern cabin on Ennis Lake at Clute's Camp in Montana. This is a general view of the camp there. Really, they don't look too fancy, but they were comfortable and clean. Beautiful Jackson Hole, Wyoming country, and the Grand Teton Mountains in the background. This is Yellowstone Falls back in Yellowstone Park. The chronological sequence is a little screwed up, but who cares? Charlie, that was not Terry going up those stairs. That was Charlie Dye going up those stairs. These scenes were shot before Terry was even a gleam in my eye. Some scenery along the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. You really have to see this country in person to realize its magnificence. Again, some Wyoming plains scene with the background of the mountains. Thank you. And kids, that's your mother. I don't know who the child is. I think it must be little Butch McKinney. Yeah, there's a moose in the background there if you look closely. Hard to see, though. You can see the movement. That's what it is, a big old bull moose. Charlie, I believe these pictures along here were taken when we went camping out of Yellowstone. The time when you had eaten too many green peaches. I think you'll recall that vividly. Another shot of the Teton Mountains there in the Jackson Hole, Wyoming country. This is just coming up on the end of this segment. We have a whole lot more and going to have some with a lot of family scenes in them. Some of them kind of hectic. Some are priceless. Don't go away. There's more to follow. Coming up shortly. Segments were made. This segment of it was made subsequent to the first part of this, and I have a lot of commentary to give later on. This is Ennis Lake. In Butte, Montana, this is Bill and Mabel Clute and Charlie and his mother. This is the general campground area. That's old Mabel. All right, scene shifts. This is Charlie getting ready to go to school in Butte for his first day in 1947. Bye. Oh, quick, short day. He's coming out now. That was his schoolhouse and his first day in school. Montana, that big smokestack in the background is an Anaconda Copper Company smelter. These were just some friends of ours, the Bradys, that lived in Butte. He was my hunting buddy. He also flew. We have some scenes of one of his airplanes after a while, but old Jess was a real mountain man. We call him Mountain Goat Brady. He'd walk you down in the mountains when you were hunting. There's his airplane. And he was later killed on final approach to the Butte Airport. It stalled and spun in on final, turning on the final approach and killed him. And old Charlie did a big wink. I flew for Jack Gamelin when I first went to work for him. We were doing aerial surveying. That's why we were in Butte at the time. And these are scenes of Charlie's first heavy snowfall in Butte. He's having a ball. These are just neighborhood scenes from our house there that we lived in and when we were in Butte. Charlie remembers that house well because he remembers the closet episode. You can ask him about that. Next door neighbors had some chickens. They had two hens and eight roosters, and boy, did those roosters have a time. The snow was sliding down a big picture window that was in the front of the house. And he was throwing snowballs at the picture window, and they were sticking and sliding down. The car in front was our 41 Chevrolet at that time. This was our only transportation. The scenes from the Butte Airport there. That was, again, my twin beats that I was flying doing aerial survey work for Jack Ammon out of San Antonio. Boy, how the years have flown. There's a picture of our house we lived in Butte, and our next door neighbors. I remember Charlie telling the neighbors about the cats chewing off a piece of elk that I gave them. It was in the garage frozen, and I gave it to him, and I cut a corner off where the cats had chewed on it, and he had to go squeal on me. Birds go south in the wintertime. Sequence a little screwed up on this. This was prior to the snow scene. In actuality, we were on our way to Ennis Lake to go fishing, and this was a herd of sheep that was moving along the highway. We had to thread our way through. This is one of our fish that we caught out of Ennis Lake, Charlie. It was old Wade McKinney that flew with me for, 11 years or so. He and Bonnie were sure seriously intent on their fishing. There's the McKinney family and all of the Dye family that we had at that time. That's Skip and Mac and Little Butcher, Sherry, and Charlie and Bonnie. Thank you. suggest some scenes along the Clark Fork River Highway between Butte and Ennis Lake, and some mountain tunnels that the highway was pushed through. Yellowstone Park, and that's Old Faithful Geyser just erupted. Erupts on a very regular basis. I forget now, something like an hour and 40 minutes. This is just one of the geyser pools. I believe this is what they call the gem pool. And the water isn't quite boiling temperature, but it's hot enough to steam, and it's just crystal clear. There's a good shot of the gem pool. Beautiful. Okay, this is a little island out in the middle of the Fraser River in Yellowstone Park. And we stopped and watched this cow that's out on the island give birth to that calf. And she's just cleaning it up after it got to its legs, got up on its hind legs there. Nice going for its first dinner. Look at that sucker suck. Chance to film something like that or see it. Too bad this was before the days of the camcorder with the zoom lenses and all. I sure would like to have some close-ups of it. I've often wondered if that calf got off that island across that river without drowning. Okay, the scene changes rather drastically. This is just a recap of the scenes that are forthcoming. I'll try to give you a little narration as we go. This is the grandmother and Grandpa Ellis's home there in Houston. This was built about the time Bonnie and I got married. I think it was started just before we got married. This is Eileen's husband and her oldest daughter, Carolyn, and her husband, Red, there briefly. Carolyn is she's a year or so younger than Charlie. Teacher with the San Antonio public school system. Her mother is that. Carolyn's mother is. No, Carolyn, I'm sorry. Carolyn, hoisted aloft by her father, Red Bond. He's an Episcopal minister living in Kerrville. Okay, left to right is Charlie, Grandma Ellis, Bonnie, and Ann. What a dude. We bad. Okay, these are family scenes that we shot over at Billy and Joyce Ailey's house. There's a lot of coming and going of kids in here. That's little David. It's little David Ellis right there. And old Charles, he's looking after him, isn't he? I remember Charlie was the first grandchild on both sides of the family. So he was kind of the elder brother to them all. There's Mike, and just previously that was Bobby Ailey. There's Bobby again. Looked like it was an Easter occasion. There's Mike again. Like the same people, do they? And there's Owen looking young and pretty. Ooh, wasn't she risque showing that much leg and that ruffle on her dress? She was in high cotton. There's Aunt Billy. And Grandmother Ellis again. Looking rather dapper. She had lost some teeth and she's trying to cover up her snags. That was Charlie swinging Carolyn, and there is Grandmother Di and Eileen and Bonnie. Eileen and Bonnie were both pregnant. Bonnie with Terry and Eileen with Barbara. There's Preacher Red. Red wasn't a preacher at that time. He was a commercial salesman from Firestone. Charlie will remember this big tree across the street in front of Grandmother Di's house, and I don't remember the kid's name that played there. This is Joyce's cousin. I don't recall his name, but that was little old Mike, and this fellow's holding him up there for us all to enjoy. this was great uncle Dan Floor. He was Grace's uncle. I think Grace was a Floor before she married Clarence Ellis. Joyce Ailey, for those who don't remember him, when he was a young man. Just neighborhood scenes from Billy's and Joyce's front yard there in Houston. This was shortly after World War II. In San Antonio, and this was our first new car, a 1948 DeSoto. What a beauty. This is a little Ann. She was toting Terry. This is a scene from the Breckenridge Zoo. San Antonio with the elephants performing, and I bet you'll see a scene of a bunch of kids riding on elephants, and old Charlie was right in there with them. Just some shots of the house that we lived in San Antonio, and of the surrounding neighborhood. And there's old Terry enjoying a bath in the kitchen sink. Are these priceless? There's Terry taking his first steps. What a tiger. How many times do you pick yourself up after you fall in this life? the films here, that break was necessitated by that. And this is a sunset scene in San Antonio there. This is back to Terry when he was just a few days before he started his first steps that you saw pictures of there. That's Bonnie and Ann and Terry there at a house in San Antonio. Bubba up. He's gonna get his picture in there with his baby brother. Right, that hair dude was just... What a dude. Where did the years get away to? That for an Easter Bunny deposit. San Antonio to aerial shots of Miami, Florida. Your mother and I were headed to the Bahamas for a couple of days of vacation and fishing. Man-made islands in Biscayne Bay. Bahamas, we stayed at the resort called Butlins in the Bahamas, and these are some scenes of the boats and the waters and the resort area. Here we were out fishing, and I think Bonnie had just hooked on to a barracuda. You'll get a close-up of it. Oh, what a struggle. See those waters to believe them. They just crystal clear. You just I don't know how deep they are, but you can see the coral reefs and everything, and the fish all swimming around. It's just beautiful. Catch for the day, 1950. The swimming pool had salt water in it. Wasn't very much fun. Taken as the title suggests.